I am Dr. KOSHAL DANI from Arvinda Hospital, and my topic for today is VKH syndrome. What has really changed? Trends in clinical profile, treatment modalities in a referral center in South India. As we all know, a VKH is a bilateral granulomatous panuveitis associated with autoimmunity against the melanocytes. Talking about our study, in group 1 patient which were treated with only oral steroids and group 2 which were treated with early parenteral steroids and immunosuppressants. As we can all see, the RP degeneration and peripapillary atrophy were much more in group 1 patient as compared to group 2 patients. The four phases of VKH are prodromal, acute uveitic, convalescent and chronic recurrent. VKH can be severely associated with serous macular detachment, disc edema, vitreitis as well as sunset glow fundus. The methodology. The study was conducted, it is a retrospective analysis conducted on 89 patients in a tertiary eye care center during the duration of 2010 to 2019. The inclusion criteria were all patients with VKH irrespective of age and satisfying VKH criteria at any stage. The exclusion criteria were individuals with significant media opacities, primary retinal diseases, patient having history of ocular surgeries prior to the onset, and history of ocular trauma prior to the onset. Excuse me. As we all know, the study was conducted between 2010 to 2019. We had certain milestones. From 2010 to 2012, the patients were treated with only steroids, whereas in 2014, EDIOCT and FFA were done, but only and only in feasible patients. From 2014 to 2016, early immunosuppressants and parenteral steroids were started, and that is the group 2 of our study. From 2016 to 2018, it was mandatory in all the patients to do EDIOCT and FFA. So what is the future? Yes, the biologicals in the treatment of VKH can be looked as the future. So now, therapeutically, what has really changed? Immunosuppressants which we used were azathioprine and methotrexate, early parenteral steroids in the dose of in the form of IV methylprednisolone and full dose steroid, the oral steroid 1 mg/kg. In our study, we had 22 males and 66 females with a mean age of 35.5 and range of 26 to 55 years in male, and females with a mean age of 40 and range of 11 to 70. Looking to the vision at presentation and comparing it with vision at final visit, the group 1 where there was good visual prognosis and in group 2 were almost the same, but when they finally presented to us after the treatment, there were 80% of patient in group 2 because they were treated with immunosuppressants as well as steroid, whereas in group 1 there were only 73% which had a better visual prognosis. The patient which did not improve or improved well as with having poor visual prognosis were 15% in group 1 whereas it was only 10% in group 2. The extraocular manifestations of VKH which we encountered are tinnitus, sensory neural hearing loss, alopecia, vitiligo and meningismus. VKH, as we all know, presents with anterior segment as well as posterior segment signs. In group 1, the significant anterior segment signs were cataract and glaucoma, whereas in group 2, they were significantly lower. The posterior segment signs like CNVM, sunset glow fundus, Dehlenfux nodule and peripapillary atrophy were much higher as compared to the group 2 of our study. Now, going forward and comparing between the number of recurrences and number of complications in group 1 with only oral steroids and group 2 with parenteral steroids and immunosuppressants. The number of complications in group 1 were 47 eyes with more than 2 complications, whereas we got only 37 eyes with more than 2 complications in group 2. Group 1, we had 45 eyes with more than 2 times of recurrences, whereas in group 2, there were only 19 eyes with more than 2 complications. There were some studies which helped us compare our data with the patients in group 1, which were Ono et al., Rupsaman et al., and Murthy et al. Coming to the discussion part of our study, women were much more commonly affected by VKH than males. Males had poor visual outcome despite aggressive treatment. In acute disease, exudative retinal detachment and RCS elevation were seen, whereas in chronic disease, sunset glow fundus, Dehlenfux nodules and PPA were seen. Group 2 patients had less complications and recurrences than group 1, which was statistically significant. We had some limitations of our study, where classical Sigvaris sign was not seen, whereas we could have gone for HLA typing, ICG and CSF for our study. But the strengths were the sample size was large and adequate, duration of study was long, and the study was conducted in a single center by a single examiner. Literature search supporting the group 2 of our study. Which showed cumulative evidence with first line use of steroid sparing immunosuppressants, which will help to prevent complications. And FFA and SDOCT are definitely important adjuncts for initial diagnosis and early monitoring of treatment response. Another study comparing corticotherapy versus corticotherapy and immunosuppression showed that immunosuppressant with corticosteroids, there was recurrence rate was significantly lower. The third study which supported us is clinical features and visual outcome study, which showed that in selected cases there was excellent visual outcomes and low rate of recurrences. A study which showed earlier immunomodulatory treatment, which is associated with visual outcomes in a subset of patient, which showed in a subset it is the visual outcome is better. So we definitely have three take home messages. First, EDIOCT and FFA should be mandatory in all the cases of VKH. Second and most important, early parenteral steroids combined with early immunosuppressants, it results in better visual outcome, reduced recurrence rate and reduced complications. And third, what are the directions for future research? Yes, biologicals are the future in the treatment of VKH.